judge today denied separate requests by Patricia and Alan Prue for new lawyers. The two are accused of luring a St. Johnsbury teacher from her home, sexually assaulting and murdering her. Melissa Jenkins' body was later found in the Connecticut River. News Channel 5's Jack Thurston has the story from Vermont Superior Court.
State versus Patricia.
With trembling hands and heaving breaths, Patricia Prue spoke publicly for the first time since police and prosecutors labeled her one of the most heinous criminals in Vermont.
We're just not getting anywhere.
The Waterford woman is charged in the brutal March 2012 death of Melissa Jenkins, a beloved St. Johnsbury Academy science teacher. Investigators say the crime was fueled by sexual obsession and that Prue schemed with her husband, Alan, to lure and snatch Jenkins, beat and strangle her, then dump her body in the Connecticut River. Police said the earliest part of that attack unfolded in front of Jenkins' toddler son. Now, the husband and wife, both of whom pled not guilty to the charges against them, want their respective defense attorneys fired and replaced.
My lawyer doesn't seem to have any defense for me after all this time.
I feel he's using my wife as a source of leverage against me.
But Judge Mary Miles Teachout denied their requests, saying criminal suspects don't always have to like their appointed lawyers to get good representation.
They're trying to do whatever they can to delay the case.
Melissa Jenkins' relatives were glad with that ruling, calling it just one tiny step on what's already been a long road to justice.
I don't know if there ever is going to be true closure in this, because there's a little boy that, we all care about, and those people obviously don't. They're just heathens.
There are still some more issues to iron out before these cases go to trial, including a newly filed motion that Alan Prue's case be heard out of county. As it stands right now, we're talking later this year or early 2014 for this pair of murder trials. In St. Johnsbury, Jack Thurston, News Channel 5.